Greetings and welcome one and all. Welcome back to Robocraft and to the Hot Dog Bot, which I've received quite a few good suggestions of names. And I'm actually going to go with one of those. I'm going to change the Hot Dog Bot's name to the Bot Dog. We're not going to have the Bot Dog Bot. That sounds a little bit redundant. But there we go, the Bot Dog. Now, I've also received pretty solid advice on where and how to fit my components. So we're going to have a little bit of a play around with the Hot Dog Bot, and then we're going to start designing a new bot, I think. Down here or up there? That's the question. Right, we want to move this over there. Then what we want to do next is we are going to affix, hopefully, a radar in here. We can go with a tier 5 radar, perhaps. Ah, no, we cannot. Maybe if we were to place one block there, we could fit a radar. Yes! Ha ha! Fantastic! Now, what else were we to do inside? There was the radar. Helium blocks, that was the other thing. Now, as I said, I'm only going to be testing this out briefly before we move to the next tier. Have we got any tier 5 helium blocks? Are there such things? Oops, the text has gone a little bit wonky there, but no, it doesn't look like there are. So we'll just go ahead and use regular helium blocks then on the insides. Let's pop a couple of these along the sides just to lift this up just a tad. Unfortunately, we have now moved into tier 5. Tier 6, which is not good. So we're going to get rid of you two on either side and see if we can keep going. No, still can't go. Wow, this is less than ideal. Honestly, I'm a little bit disappointed. Let's get rid of you. And then let's also get rid of you. Ha ha! There we go. Right, let's hope that we can actually seal this up then. If we can, then we're going to take this out and we're going to test it a little bit. Hopefully that helium will make a bit of a difference. I'm not sure if it will, though, but still, I do like how we've internalized the vast majority of the functional components in this bot. I'm really quite pleased with that. Let's jump into a little practice round and see if the helium has made even the slightest bit of difference to our ability to move quickly. Though, of course, we have taken away two forward thrusters. I may get rid of the reverse thrusters instead, but we'll see. The helium should make things a little bit better, maybe. I'm not too certain about that. Not too certain at all. Let's go off this and see what we can do. Oh, the helium is making it easier for us to fly around, though. Oh, wait. We're going to go into a spin. I should have kept steering into that spin. Okay. Well, let's wait for our flipper to come online. There we go. And huge amounts of flips because of the helium. Wow, I'm liking that. It's been so long since I've actually used helium in a bot that I forgot that it was an option, honestly. And it's a bloody good option too. Well done, everyone who suggested that. I like it. But what I don't like is the fact that we can't go forward too fast. How fast can we go backward? None too fast there either. You know what? I think we're going to give this a try, as is. We haven't got a huge amount of speed. Perhaps I could swap some of the tier 6 guns for tier 5s. That might give me enough room to put those tier 4s back down there. Let's place you on either side there. Oh, that's glorious. In fact, at that point, we can get rid of these. Yeah, I quite like that. That worked out well. Let's shape the Hot Dog Bot once again, and then place down our forward thrusters again, once again. We might even be able to fit a couple more of these in this time. Oh, that's good. I like that. We've got a lot of forward thrust now. Probably a little bit too much. I'm going to need an extra 4, aren't I? Yes, I am. Very well, I should be able to stretch to buying an extra 4. These are tier 4 thrusters. Yes, they are. There we go. Now, when we do make a new bot, I am probably going to go with a three-ski design. A steering ski at the front, and then forward propulsion skis at the back. Now, how was that? That was slightly offset, if I recall. No, actually it wasn't. Never mind. I wonder why that's there then. There we go, that looks a little bit better. Perfect. Could I even sneak one in there? I could. Ooh. That is an awful lot of thrust at that point. Dare I use that much I dare, I think. Let's be honest. If you're going to put any thrusters on there, you may as well put too many. Wait. I'm not playing Kerbal Space Program. What is this logic doing here? I really, really should be a little bit more careful. Kerbals thrive in risky, stupid situations. The bot dog does not. But I think this should be an interesting bot to take out for at least one or two battles before we get to designing a new one. So I shall see you on the battlefield. And welcome back. Now, something I haven't mentioned yet is that this is post hotfix that has been released. Now, I'm not sure at all. Ooh, we've got a lot more speed now. That is going to so easily tip us up. But this is post hotfix that Free Jam have released. We're not sure yet. I haven't played it enough to notice whether this has made a big enough change to the problems that we were having. My fingers and, in fact, my toes remain crossed. But some people have been reporting that there are still issues. But I've not encountered too many so far, all things told. Oh, no, he's staying close. Is he going to pop his head up? Or is he going down this way? He's going down this way. Very well, I should come and meet you, shall I? Hello? Hello? Ah, Diamond Blast. He didn't go this way at all. He was tricking me. But I'm really liking how maneuverable the hotbot is so far. Like, there's someone over there, another plasma bomber. Is he going to be coming up this way? I just don't know. You know what? I need to get out there and start fighting and stop dilly-dallying, looking for something in the skies for me to kill. There we go. We'll spot you again at the very least. Will we actually be able to score even the slightest hit? I'm not sure. Yes, apparently we will, and it will be the only hit that is required. I hit him once, he died. That must have been a particularly rough design there. Now, let's get up here, get into this fight. Got two plasma bots. Oh, Avak, bring back the Monkey Lord. I've had so many people terribly upset that the hotbot has taken the... the bot dog. Hotbot. Damn it. The bot dog has taken the place of the Monkey Lord. The Monkey Lord's been gone for ages, don't you know? I had to take that apart to get all the parts for the Solenopsis and Wictor upgrade. But I have every intention of going back eventually. Oh, this is going to be bad. This is bad, bad, bad times. Thankfully, I frightened them. But I need to be on the move. Let's not let them hit me. That's right. Keep focusing on me while my allies take a shot at you. How many of us remain? Their medic is doing a good job there, I fear. We need to get back to the base and stop them. Maybe if we can make the long range, the snipers, rail bots come to us, we will have the advantage since they will be in motion, thus not have their most accurate shots available. Plus, we'll be able to dictate where and when we fight. Ooh, there is someone over yonder. Let's get a shot on you. Well, we hit him, but oh dear. Problem with skis, I'm about to fall off, I'm fairly certain. Let's try and take you out of the sky before you can get over here. I am going down, aren't I? Yes, yes I am. Well, oh, never mind. Ha! I didn't go down too badly. Right, let's keep on the move. Those skis are a menace, though, when it comes to trying to stay on a ledge I have found so far. But, you know what? The hot dog bot. The hot dog bot? No! The bot dog! This is what happens when I change names. I get used to calling it one thing, and then all of a sudden I'm calling it something else. This is far too much for my simple, simple brain to handle. But, as I was saying, the bot dog is handling very well. Come on, come on. Prove me right. Ha-ha! I didn't even need to use my alignment rectifier, it just did it. Oh, that's so good. Alright, I'm coming, Kevin Box. I can't do a whole lot, but I am coming. Hello. Stop shooting my allies, you scallywags! I disapprove, that's right, get back. And you there, die. Now I need to be on the move. Because you've got my number, haven't you? Haha! That's right, perfect timing. Don't bump into me if you can avoid it, because that bad things happen when you do. I've only got two guns left. This is not going to go well for me, I don't think. I need to be on the move so he can't easily get a shot. Oh, I need the other side facing him. That's what I need. Oh, alas, I wasn't able to hold him off. Good luck, Kevin. Oh, that's a shame. But it was a fairly fun little battle, and certainly I think the bot dog has gotten much, much better in terms of maneuverability. I felt much more mobile and much faster in that game. So clearly, that helium has done a huge, huge, been a huge benefit to the bot. I like it. Now, I'm not going to tear apart the bot dog. I'm going to go to one of the other empty garages, and I'm going to do something else. Now, for those who are deeply concerned that the Monkey Lord has gone, don't worry. We will be getting the Monkey Lord back because I have build tutorials for the Monkey Lord. That's one of the nice things about having recorded build tutorials is when I take apart a bot, I can just put it back together later on. No, I think I'm going to reuse the currently empty I Come In Peace garage. Now, I'm going to go ahead and pause the recording and I'm going to go through all of my other bots and get their first victory of the day reward. And when we come back, we're going to start work on a new bot. So see you then. And welcome back to Bay One, Mr. Plow. We're going to have to see whether I'm going to be able to make anything to live up to that name, but I've got a plan in mind. Now, I have gone through all of my bots and gotten the first victory of the day, except for the Firestorm, because there's a lot that needs to be done to the Firestorm to make it viable, and that is for another video, really. I don't want to just do that off screen, but yes, back to the Mr. Plow it is. So, the first thing we are going to need for Mr. Plow is some skis. And as I mentioned, I'm thinking we're going to go with skis that are in a bit more of a triangle configuration. So we'll build something out a little bit along these lines to give us that base to start working with. Now we'll do something here as well. There we go. This is our base for Mr. Plow. I'm not sure exactly how long I want to make it. I fancy something a little bit longer than I had to begin with. I do seem to have a problem with underestimating how much space I'm going to need on my build. So let's try and start as we mean to go on with that one. Now, we're going to need a steering ski. And we're going to place that about there, I would say. That seems like a reasonable place to put a steering ski, if you were to ask me. We'll build this back just a tad as well. And we'll see what we can do here. Now, I am leaving this area conspicuously empty, and that is for a particular reason. Now, before we get there, we're going to need a couple more skis. As you can see, I do have quite a lot of RP from just going through and getting my first victory of the day bonuses on all of the bots that I had available. Right, we want these skis. Now, the question is, could we fit four? Can they stack next to each other? They cannot. Which is a bit of a shame. I'm wondering if maybe I can do something like this. It means that we've only got one ski that's steering us, but, well, maybe that isn't too bad. In fact, we could have some like that. Okay, this is starting to look a bit interesting. Now, we are going to want fairly high tier thrusters on this. We're not going to be messing around this time, no. We're going straight for the big boys. So there we go. We are in tier 5 after all, so it shouldn't come as any surprise that we're going to use fairly high tier thrusters. I wouldn't mind some more, though. Let's go and see what we can buy with our 347,000 RP. My lord, we could go straight for the T9s if we really wanted to. Don't think we really do. We're going to go for two T6s instead. There we are. That'll do for us for now. Let's place a thruster there. and a thruster here as well. That should give us quite a significant amount of forward thrust. Now, for the name Mr. Plow, we are of course required by law to have a plow. So, we're going to have a see of how we can do that. What kind of... we don't have tier 9 shields yet. Okay, we're going to try and make a plow out of tier 5 shields, and it shouldn't actually be too difficult. Let's move this forward a little bit on either side. And do something along these lines. Here we go. This is our plow for Mr. Plow. Not the best snow plow in the world, I grant you. But still, it has a certain charm, I think you're going to have to admit. Let's see. Can I place these on this side instead? Probably not, since it's symmetrical. Well, we'll see what we can do with that. But I am pretty happy with having some shields on here, at the very least. I could possibly... Yeah, I could put these shields over my vulnerable... Oh, there we are. There we go. Over the vulnerable thrusters there. Would be probably quite wise, honestly. Now, you know what? I think I would prefer to build this out just a tad. Like so. In fact, can we move these forward? Oh, yes, we can actually move them forward. That's... good. I like the aesthetic that we're slowly building up here. Let's move you properly forward. There we are. Fantastic, Mr. Plow. A work of art in the making right here. Of course, we want to shape the blocks slightly. What would an AVAC bot be without shaped blocks? It wouldn't be an AVAC bot. That is how you can tell the forgeries from the real deal. If it has an obscene amount of unnecessary... shaped blocks and prisms and tetras all over it that are probably interfering with the function of the bot, then it is one of mine. If it is built purely for function and does really well, and whoever's piloting it is actually good at the game, that's how you know it's absolutely not me. It is an imposter. The Undapper Sod. There we go. Let me get this up here as well. Bit of a cage for our thrusters. I'm not sure I'm going to do the same down here. I may do. That is up for debate. Probably not, in fact. We'll just build off a bit of a defensive area down here for those. I just want to keep them safe, basically. And up the top, then, we'll just bridge this gap with these. There we go. So we've got our thruster cage. I'm liking that. Yes, yes, it's all looking rather snazzy, if you ask me. We'll probably have some lights or something at the back. Now, underneath, we will go for... I'm going to splurge on a new T7 jammer. I may not use it, but I'm going to splurge on it all the same. We'll place it about there. There we go, that's not a bad position. Alright, we're getting somewhere, little by little. Let's see. We've used up so much already, and we haven't even actually got any functional parts to this yet, but damn it, it looks good. And let's go for another one. This is a very heavily defended bot. You may have already noticed. However, I'm thinking we need something pretty snazzy at the front. I'm thinking one of these. Now that is a plow. That is now... a genuine plow. Not a plow of snow, of course. A plow of machines. We are going to plow the enemy out of our way. And it is going to be most glorious. I can tell you now. And I'm just adding some embellishments purely for the sake of adding embellishments. Let's have a look. Where else do we want to add something? That is the question. Well, I quite like this rear area, though I think we need to properly craft a cockpit. So that is what we're going to work on next. And yeah, I quite like this. I'm sorry everyone that wants me to use the what's the call? The Triforce armor. I was really struggling for the word then, but I just can't. It looks ugly. And if you think it... Well, okay, sometimes it doesn't. But to make it look good, you generally have to sacrifice its use. And if you're going to do that anyway, you may as well just not go with it and build for aesthetics right from the get-go. That's my take on it anyway. Now, for this bot, I think we're going to go with... Well, we're in tier 7 now, which is a bit higher than I really would like. That's probably because of you, isn't it? Yes, yes, it's because of you. Let's see if we can't build a... T6 bot, can we get one more T8 blade there? Now the thing with Mr. Plow is because I'm building it from the ground up to be in the mid-tiers, it's not going to be too hard for me to take it a little further. Like if I really want to do, I could go around and replace all of this armor with tier 7. I don't just yet. So I'm gonna steer clear of that for the time being, but it is definitely something that I could do. Now, where are my tier 6 helium cubes? Here we are. Pilot seat, you're just going to have to put up with having all of these pressurized containers right next to you. Someone did point out that helium is not explodey. That is very true. But any gas under pressure does have the tendency to turn any metal can that they happen to be in into a grenade if they get shot. So I'm still averse to having my pilots just sat there with helium all around him. But yeah, you know what, he's just going to have to... suck it up. Sorry, but this is a war. Well, kind of. I don't actually think it's a war. I think this is just some sort of blood sport of the future. Nevertheless. Right. That's a decent bit of helium there. Let's go ahead and place some helium here as well. There we go. This should give us the lift that we're going to need to avoid... having a repeat of the issues that we've had previously, which is that speed just really wasn't there. And on a bot that's more or less designed for speed, you kind of that is a bit of a problem. I've got to be honest. See, this doesn't look particularly nice. I've got to be honest, but it may just work. We'll do it, and we'll see what we can do. There we go. You know what? I'm gonna get rid of you. Yeah, that looks a bit better. Still not amazing, but it's not terrible either. We'll see. We will see. Now, let's go back to the T6 launchers. Ah, we're back in T7. Damn it. Well, I guess it's probably these. If I had to put my finger... Oh, actually, no. Well, it will be, since we're in tier 7, they'll go down quickly. If we take away these shields as well, I wonder which is the highest contributor, these or the shields? It was definitely the shields. Okay, well, we'll live with that then. We'll take those down just a little bit. I would prefer this to remain in tier 6 primarily for now. Let's build this up just a little bit out here as well. Get another plasma there. I really, really must say, I really wish that you could build plasmas off the sides. But it just isn't to be, it seems. And I consider this quite unfortunate. But that actually looks a lot better. Now that we don't have to worry about the shield being there, this does actually seem to have a bit better shape to it. Some people ask me where I get my inspiration from for my bots. Nowhere. I just start building and I let my creativity tell me where it wants to take the design. Half the time, the design ends up being rubbish. Usually I can make the bot look good, but actually work good. Well, you've seen the results there. They speak for themselves. Doesn't always go to plan. But I'm generally happy with the designs I have all the same. Let's get that there. In fact, we've now got a little bit more room for helium, I would say. So why don't we have another helium there, and another helium over on this side as well, like so. Okay, that's not too bad. We were probably going to have a decent amount of thrust here. Now, we're not going to make the mistake of forgetting to put... right, we're going to need many more of those. But we're not going to make the mistake of forgetting to put directional thrusters on this one. Let's go ahead and buy 10. We've still barely dented the amount of RP I've got, so I could easily see us taking Mr. Plow into the higher tiers just from... yeah, that would actually be a good direction. So now that gives me a little bit of reverse thrust at the front, at the back there. Where am I going to fit the rest of the reverse thrust is the question. That's a little bit more tricky. That's a lot more tricky, actually. I guess I could have a bit of reverse thrust at the front. But this is going to be one of the first things to be shut off, unfortunately. We've also got a few little nooks and crannies down here, but I imagine we're going to be using those primarily for thrusters to help us steer. So, it looks like if I really want to connect this there, I'm going to have to do this. And that isn't going to sit well with me unless... Oh, I can. Okay, this works. This definitely is something we can work with. Yes, I like it. Very well, Mr. Plow. You've got a slightly different shape at the back there, but it still works out together and it almost looks intentional. And that is the best kind of thing to do. Right, let's go ahead and get some tier 2s. We're going to have to buy a couple more, but we are almost there. There we go. Wow, they're cheap. I'm sure at one point I thought that was expensive, but man, that is so cheap. I wish everything cost only that much. Right, we'll have a little bit of steering at the front here. And then a little bit further back as well. Can we fit some underneath, maybe? Not with ease. But, you know what? We're going to do it anyway. There we go. So our steering skis will help. We've got two steering skis, so a little bit of redundancy at the front. Do we have any kind of shielding that I can stick there? See, I really don't think we do. Ooh, you know what? Maybe. Let me just check that these are actually functionally the same. So, 36 flops. 36 flops. 1,913 robo ranking. Same there. 513 armor. Yep, and 5,126. Yes, these are in fact exactly the same. So, we're going to go with those. And... No. What? Have I only got one side? Did I only buy the shoulder guards for one side? Please tell me I did not. It does, in fact, appear I did. Alright, okay, well, let's grab five of these as well, then. The numbers I've got are one or two. As you may be aware, everyone basically had different numbers. So, my shoulder pads are one and two, but yours may very well be different. And I quite like that, honestly. I think that's kind of neat. Could we fit these over there as well? Oh, that... It's cool, but I'm kind of not sure about it over the basic ones. Let's have a quick look at how that would look if I just had the basic ones. I don't know. As cool as those parts are, I'm not sure it goes quite with this bot. I like the very blue effect. I think it works with the aesthetic that we're going for here. Very snowy color. Yeah, we're going to stick with this. There we go. A little bit more armor for the cockpit. All right. We are almost there, ladies and gentlemen. Watch this not work now. It'll be hilarious. But, well, hilarious for everyone but me, because I'll feel a little bit sad. I could maybe fit that in, possibly. Maybe. No, absolutely not. Wow. I could perhaps fit it down here instead. No. I guess I'll have to go there then. We'll have the exposed helium, but that's fine. We've got a radar, we've got plasma, and we've got a lot of thrusters. Let's take this out into the practice arena and see how this goes. I am actually genuinely quite pleased with the way this looks, if nothing else. We'll have to see if this can actually do any fighting. Now then, how fast can you move? Okay, you're not too slow on your feet. I would prefer it if you were a little bit faster, but you know what? You're not tipping, which is good. Let's see. I would prefer just a little bit more forward speed. But we'll see how this goes first. Now, if I need to suddenly reverse, how fast can I move backwards? Well, you know what? You can move back pretty quickly. I'm not at all unhappy with that. There's a little part of me that's thinking a rudder would be perfect for this. And then I just fly off things like this. But let's see what the helium can do for us. We're spinning out. We're in flight. We are about to touch down. And we touch down terribly. But that's okay. This isn't a flyer. This is a plow. And I kind of refuse to make it a flyer because that would more or less be going against what it is meant to be. Hello, Gary. But no, I'm pretty pleased with that. A rudder might make steering just a little bit better. And I am considering it. I guess we could stick one on there. It's only going to be a T5. So let's see if that will push us forward too much. One rudder, please. We'll have it there. Ah, okay, that's not too bad. Could we bring a block down? No, but we might be able to bring a block like this. Yes, we can. Fantastic. You know what? There's a part of me that just wants to do this. And I think I will, because I can. Okay, we'll roll with this. It would probably be a little bit better just one block higher up, but if I did that, then this wouldn't work out for me, and that would be a bit of a shame. But at the same time, let's see, what can I do to make this work? Is there anything I can do? I think there may be. Let's bring this out and bring these up. Connect that there. Oh, okay, that looks good. Wow. I mean, it doesn't look especially good there, I suppose, but I don't know. No, I think it creates too much of a dome. It looks a little bit silly. So I'm afraid, Ruddy, as convenient as it would be to have you there, I'm afraid you're going to have to go down here instead, because that just makes the rear of the vehicle look that much better. But I will move that component, the T6 plasma, just a little bit forward. There we go. Perfect. Okay, let's quickly take this out again and see if the rudder has had any effect, on its ability to glide. Now, I'm fairly certain that we're probably getting towards the point where I need to wrap this episode up, but I think I'll go for at least one battle in this new bot. Oh my lord, look at that! The Mr. Plow can glide like a pro! Perhaps a little bit too well, Mr. Plow! Oh dear, Mr. Plow. We're gonna have to have words, you and I. I definitely need some downward thrusters then. I hadn't been counting for that, but okay. No, lesson learned. Don't just add a rudder willy-nilly, because I've got so much thrust on this thing that it can quite happily just take off. So, first and foremost, we are going to need some downward thrust. Where, though, is the question? You know what? Maybe if I do something like this. There we are. One there. One on that side as well. Now, the problem with that is it's going to be very easy to lose that block, and thus lose you. So I'll do a little bit of triforcing there. I don't actually mind the kind of sawtooth effect that you get with that kind of stuff. But and since we've already got steering skis, I'll have those there as well. I'm not going to worry too much about upward thrust. It's the downward thrust that I want, because again, I don't really want this to fly. I want it to glide maybe, but not fly. But no, I'm pretty happy with this. And I'm going to take it out as is. So, I will see you in a battle. And welcome to the battle. We are on a snowy map. The very best kind of map to christen the Mr. Plow, I feel. Okay, let's see what we can do. We haven't got a whole lot of steering. We've got a little bit of extra steering on the sides there. Really, really, must you be such a bully? You scallywag, Mr. Drac. I'll remember that name. No, I won't. But I would like to. I know I'm not going to be able to. Oh, look at that. We're gliding over the snow, which is not exactly what you want a plow to do, I guess. Not quite to spec. But nevertheless, we are making some good progress, and that is exactly what you want from this kind of bot. Oh, what a glorious leap over that hill there. Okay. Now, where are the rest of my teammates? We don't want to get too far ahead. We're not built for real tanking here. We are tier appropriate. Just. We're at the high end of the tier. Now, there is a bit of... the jury's still out a little bit on whether that ever makes a difference. whether being slightly towards the top or the bottom of your tier will put you in a fight with higher or lower people in that tier. It's still quite unknown, but you might be able to sneak up on someone here. Hello. There we go. A little bit of damage to you. Let's spin around if we can. And oh no, that was terrible, Mr. Plow. You're not showing your shields. You fool of a bot. Well, there we go. That's a little bit better. And again, in a moment. I don't think I've done enough damage there to cause any real threat to this bot, but looks like we win, and I got the kill too. But we are going to go down if we... Oh, fantastic. Thanks. Now, we are going to need to get over to the our base to make sure the enemy don't cap it. Unfortunately, we've already lost 4 people. That is not a particularly good exchange, because the enemy have only lost 2. We're going to need to get down there. Let my ally know that I will be on the way just as soon as I'm healed, but I'm not going to go there without 100% health, because I will die, simply put. Alright, let's go! Can we get over there? Oh, we can. That is fantastic. Let's get a bit of downward thrust. Steering as well. In the sky, not very much. I really do actually need to put a little bit better steering thrusters there, but we have lost this one, unfortunately. That is most unsatisfactory. Nevertheless, it has taught me that I do need slightly better directional thrusters. Now, let's see how much we got for that battle. It's not going to have been a very good one, so I'm going to jump into another one before we wrap this episode up, I feel. We got 1 kill at the very least, 3,614 RP, but we do need slightly more of an ability to change direction. That is a need. We've got a little bit at the front there. As much as I don't like doing this, we're going to take you away. Sorry, but it's needed. Very, very sorry. Can I attach this there? No, I cannot. Such a shame. I could possibly push those shields forward, give myself a little bit more room to add additional components. But no, I think that is probably going to be enough. We'll take this straight back out and see what we can do. So let's see how quickly we can get a game. Whether I need to cut out the weight. No, I don't. Ah, oh, fantastic. Ah. Oh. Dry arid landscape. Well, I guess I could plow the sand, but that's kind of like trying to sweep up the desert. I think that's more of an exercise in futility, really. But we'll see how this fight goes. Good luck. Have fun, all, as always. Now, what kind of lineup of bots have we got? My lord, so many SMGs. So many SMGs. My god, love the Mohawk, dude. You're rocking that Mohawk. Right, okay, well, we have no healer. That's not the best lineup. We've got an awful lot of damage, but no way to really sustain an extended battle. This is an awkward position, but it's not a terrible one. As long as we can do enough damage fast, then we'll come out on top. But it's all down to that obnoxious amount of SMGs that we've got. Now, and also spotting, if you could spot enemies, so I know where I need to be to shoot them. That'd be great. It would be absolutely fantastic, in fact. I might even be indebted to you. Maybe. Oh, there we go. There's someone over there. There's someone up there. Let's try and get a bunch of shots over there. No, didn't manage to get any splash damage at all. And took some myself. Not so great, but that added a bit. That added a little bit of thrust there. Massive help. Right, let's reverse thrust there, just for a second or two. You know what, I'm going to go up behind them, see if I can get a flanking maneuver going, and I am remarkably fast. Oh, this is glorious. This is exactly what you need. I could probably still get faster, and I probably will experiment with trying to get there, but that'll be for another episode, I think. I've already done enough building in this one. Alright, let's see what we can do. Probably the next episode I'll just be playing with the Mr. Plow a bit. It's good to get to know a bot, and I certainly don't know the Mr. Plow very well. I don't know skis at all. That was a decent little shot there. And again, please. Good hit. 18,000. I like that. Let's get another shot over there. do as much damage as I can, as quickly as I can, to throw them off their game, really. We're just trying to draw them out so that they're not in that really tanky position down there. Let's get forward, and about there. I need to go for that medic, really. And about you? Am I going to hit? No. Damn, I got a couple of good hits in the very beginning, but I'm flailing around wildly right now and really not doing much of anything when I'm doing it. Is that going to hit? Yes. Oh, actually not a bad shot, that one. Let's do again. Have we got someone attacking us around here? No. Okay, well, that's fine. We may even win this one. Oh, that would be a nice way to end this episode, I've got to be honest. Let's get another shot in there. We're doing a decent amount of damage, but we really do need to get rid of that medic if we can. Because it's just going to be a war of attrition that we can't possibly win. Ooh, I got a kill. I am very happy with that. Okay, well, looks like you're going down there, which means I'm going down there too. Let's get down there and take him out if we can. We are about to win this battle. Hello! Take some plasma to the face. Good game. Well, that wasn't too bad. We are certainly very, very fast, and I'm liking that. I'm starting to get an idea of how I can use this bot, because that was one thing which, when I made it, I just made something to look good. Well, in my opinion, it looks good, I suppose. You may disagree. But I didn't really have much mind of what I wanted to do, other than I wanted to be able to move fast and be a plasma and have shields on the front, thus the Mr. Plow. But no, I'm starting to get an idea of how I could possibly use this bot in a fight. So as I tweak it, I'll be tweaking it towards a specific type of goal. Yes, I'm really liking the Mr. Plow. I'm really liking the skis. And in the next episode, I think we're just going to be playing around with this, probably not doing much building, just experiencing the bot a little bit more and getting to know exactly what we can expect from these skis so that we can, when we do come around to tweaking this or designing a new one, we can design it with a little bit more thought towards function and not just aesthetics. But that is for the next episode. I do hope you've enjoyed and will be joining me in the next. But until then, and as always, do take care.